Dear students, today we are going to discuss the shapes of atomic orbitals. So last class we discussed about quantum numbers, right? So magnetic quantum number describes atomic orbitals. So now, based on quantum mechanical approach, we have to find the shape of four different types of orbitals. We have s, p, d and f orbitals. We need the shapes. So the basic equation in quantum mechanics for atomic structures is Schrödinger wave equation. When the Schrödinger wave equation is solved, we get two things. One is eigenvalues. Another one is wave function. So we already discussed, when we solve the Schrödinger wave equation, we get permitted energy values. It's called the energy level or orbit or shell, right? So which is nothing but what? Eigenvalues. The permitted energy values are called eigenvalues, and we get wave function. Wave function corresponding to the eigenvalue is nothing but what? Orbitals. So by solving this Schrödinger wave equation, we get permitted energy values known as eigenvalues, and a wave function corresponding to the eigenvalues are called atomic orbitals. So two things we are getting from this Schrödinger wave equation. Now we are going to consider one electron species. For example, hydrogen. Hydrogen has just only one electron around the nucleus. Now we are going to represent the wave function for one electron species. For one electron species, the wave function psi is represented as the spherical coordinates, right? So we have a polar coordinates r, theta and phi. So these are called spherical polar coordinates. Wave function psi is represented as a spherical polar coordinates as r of r, f theta, g phi. So this is the representation of wave function in terms of spherical polar coordinates. Now this is called a radial distribution function. So r of r is called as radial distribution function, and these two are called angular distribution function. To find the shape of atomic orbitals, we need these one, a radial distribution function and angular distribution function. Next, what about wave function? As we studied already, wave function has no physical meaning. At the same time, when we take psi square, this is represent what? Probability of finding the electron. So wave function psi represents atomic orbital, and psi square represents a probability of finding the electron within a particular volume, for example orbital, right? So in a particular volume of a sphere or a space, we find the probability of electron. So probability of finding the electron in a given volume of a space is called what? Psi square. But psi has no physical meaning. Now the radial distribution function as well as angular distribution function is based on the distance as well as direction. So we find probability of finding the electron based on distance from the nucleus is called the radial distribution function, or called the radial distribution of the probability. Okay, so know the meaning. We are going to find electron, right? Probability of finding the electron in terms of what? Distance from the nucleus. The electron is from the nucleus. So how far it is from the nucleus? So probability of finding the electron based on the distance from the nucleus is called a radial distribution function, or radial distribution of the probability. At the same time, probability of finding the electron from the direction of the nucleus is called what? Angular distribution function. This describes a distance, this describes a direction. Okay. So electron will be in a particular place called the orbital. So finding the probability of the electron from the nucleus, distance from the nucleus is called the radial distribution function, and from the direction of the nucleus is called the angular distribution function, or angular distribution of the probability. First we consider a radial distribution function. So for a radial distribution function, we consider the same one electron species, hydrogen, with atomic number 1. So principal quantum number 1 and azimuthal quantum number 0. So it has only one cell. Hydrogen has just only one cell and a s orbital. Now we are going to relate the radius with angular distribution function. So we may draw a graph between the radius. Radius is expressed in terms of angstrom. Then in the y-axis, we take radial distribution function, or radial distribution of the probability. So we get a curve. So what is the inference from the graph? When the electron is far away from the nucleus, when the radius is more, right? So an electron is in the orbit. So when electron is in a particular orbit, if the radius is more, that means the electron is far away from the nucleus. What about probability of finding the electron? Radial distribution function is nothing but what? Radial distribution of the probability. That means probability of finding the electron, like a psi square. So when the radius increases, probability of finding the electron decreases. This is a major inference from this graph. When electron is moving from the nucleus, probability of finding the electron decreases. At the same time, when the radius is very small, that means when the electron is very closer to the nucleus, finding the electron will be maximum. If you take 0, very closer to the nucleus, electron is very closer to the nucleus, probability of finding the electron will be maximum. So this is the relationship between the distance electron in an orbit in a particular distance. When the distance will be more, probability of finding the electron will be less. Now consider a sphere. So when we consider an atom, nucleus is at the center and we have two spheres. So we have two spheres. The total volume of the sphere is considered as dV. The radius of inner sphere is denoted as small r, and the radius of the outer sphere is denoted as r plus dr. So we have considered an atom. Nucleus is at the center. There are two spheres, inner sphere and outer sphere. The radius value are given. So volume of the sphere is taken as dv. Right? So volume of the sphere is dv. What is the formula? Volume of a sphere, 4 by 3 pi r cube. Now we are going to differentiate this equation with respect to radius. So dv divided by dr. This is differentiated with respect to radius. 4 by 3 pi. This will be 3 r square during the differentiation. So these two will be cancelled. Dv is equal to 4 pi r square dr. Now multiply this equation by psi square. Dv psi square is equal to 4 pi r square dr psi square. So what is psi square? Probability of finding the electron in a particular volume. So for one particular atom, there are two spheres. Based on the volume, we have obtained this equation. Now we are going to draw one more graph between the radius and 4 pi r square psi square. The same x axis radius, y axis probability of finding the electron. As we drawn already, the same graph, radius is in the x axis, probability of finding the electron, psi square is in the y axis. So 4 pi r square. For this atom, we have obtained a graph, right? So for this particular atom, for example, this may be 1s orbital, right? For one particular atom, we have considered an orbital, 1s orbital. The probability of finding the electron is maximum at a distance of 0.52 angstrom. Okay. Probability of finding the electron is maximum at a distance of 0.52 angstrom. This is called the Bohr radius. So first we have Schrodinger's wave equation. By solving the Schrodinger wave equation, we get eigenvalues and the wave function, nothing but atomic orbital. We consider one electron species. For one electron species, we represent it in terms of spherical polar coordinates. Wave function is represented as in terms of spherical polar coordinates. Then there are two functions. One is a radial distribution function, another one is angular distribution function. Radial distribution function is nothing but probability of finding the electron in terms of distance from the nucleus. Angular distribution function is the probability of finding the electron in terms of direction from the nucleus. So in terms of distance from the nucleus, if you take 1s orbital, the probability of finding the electron will be maximum at very small distance, 0.52 angstrom. We know that 1s electron is very closer to what? 1s orbital. 1s orbital is very closer to the nucleus because this is in first cell. So first cell is closer to the nucleus. So distance is very small, right? So for 1s orbital, we have a probability of finding the electron maximum at 0.52 angstrom. So this is called Bohr radius. For other orbitals also, for 2s orbital, 2p orbital, 3s orbital, that will be probability of finding the electron. So at one particular distance, probability of finding the electron will be maximum for other orbitals also, right? So for 2s, 2p, 3s, 3d, for all the orbitals, we will get the graph. So this is for 1s orbital, this is for 2s orbital. So we have a probability of finding the electron maximum for 1s orbital here, then for maximum value for 2s orbital at one particular distance, right? When we move from nucleus onwards, distance increases. For 1s, 2s means a second cell, so distance will be more from the nucleus, right? Orbital will be somewhat far away from the nucleus. Then 2p, 3s, like that. So when we draw a graph between the radius and the probability of finding the electron, we get probability of finding the electron maximum at a particular distance, right? So this is for 2s orbital. Okay. Now this is very important one. When we get a graph for 2s orbital, almost probability of finding the electron is zero, right? So probability of finding the electron is increasing. It reaches a maximum for 1s orbital. again it decreases. The probability of finding the electron is decreasing at particular distance. Almost probability of electron is zero. That means electron density is almost zero. Again, this is increasing. Electron density increases. Probability of finding the electron reaches a maximum, again decreases. So this is the general trend. So 1s orbital we have already finished. For 1s orbital, maximum probability at 0.52 angstrom. For considering 2s orbital, at one particular point, probability of finding the electron is zero. Right? Electron density is zero. So this is called a nodal surface or radial node. So important one mark. So if the probability of finding the electron is zero, that means electron density zero means we call it as node, simply node. So radial node or nodal surface. So we have a nodal point, nodal plane, so many things are available. Okay, so radius can be expressed in terms of what unit? Unit of Bohr radius divided by Z. So in our book, different graphs have given for 2s orbital, 2p orbital, 3s orbital. So we will get different graph. That means maximum probability of finding the electron will be different for each orbital. Okay. So what is the major application of radial distribution function? We find at what distance maximum probability of finding the electron, and we can find number of node also. Right, from the graph we can find the number of nodes, or we can use a formula. N minus 1 is a formula to calculate number of nodes for s orbital. If you take s orbital, you can use a formula N minus 1 to calculate number of nodes. N is principal quantum number. If it is 1s orbital, means number of nodes will be 0. 1 minus 1, 0. If it is 2s orbital, 2 minus 1. For 2s orbital, 1 node will be there. For 3s orbital, 2 node will be there. So, N minus 1 is a formula to calculate number of nodes for s orbital. If you take p orbital, d orbital, means formula will be different. N minus L minus 1. We have to consider the values of principal as well as azimuthal quantum number. So this is a radial distribution function. Next one is angular distribution function, which deals with the direction of the orbital. Radial distribution function deals with orbital is how far moving from the nucleus. So at what distance the orbital is present. So radial distribution function mainly deals with orbital present at a particular distance from the nucleus. But angular distribution function deals with the direction of the orbital, right? So we have three directions, x, y and z. So what about the orientation, or what about the direction of the orbital from the nucleus? So which is discussed in angular distribution function. So we consider the same one electron species for which principal quantum number 1, azimuthal quantum number 0, magnetic quantum number 0. So it has only one orientation. So this is called what? 1s orbital. For 1s orbital, f of theta value is equal to 1 by root 2, right? Then g of phi value is equal to 1 by root 2 phi. So we have already calculated the value f of theta and g of phi. What is angular distribution function? Product of f of theta and g of phi. So this is called angular distribution function, or angular distribution of the probability. So 1 by root 2 multiplied by 1 by root 2 phi. So final answer is 1 by 2 root phi. So when we observe this formula, the angular distribution function for 1s orbital is independent of angles theta and phi. So the value is just 1 by 2 root pi. So angular distribution function is independent of angle theta and phi. So what is the shape of 1s orbital? It has just only one orientation, only one direction. So this is called spherical in shape. So we get information what? What is the shape of orbital? S orbital is spherical in shape. The x-axis, y-axis, z-axis. It has just only one orientation. That means the electron density, this is 1s orbital, the electron density is spreaded in all the directions, x, y, z. Right? So this is 1s orbital. If you take 2s orbital, so what is the shape of s orbital? Spherical shape. This is 2s orbital. Okay. X-axis, y-axis, z-axis. The electron density is spreaded in all the three dimensions. Now, you can have when you observe the 2s orbital, electron density is not spreaded uniformly. So this is the place where we don't have electron density. So here electrons are spreaded, here electrons are spreaded, or else we can say electron density. So electron density is zero in this place. So this is called what? Node. Okay. Probability of finding the electron is zero. That means electron density zero means, so this is called a node. So this is 2s orbital. As we said, number of nodes can be calculated by formula n minus 1. 1s orbital has no node. 1 minus 1, 0. 2s orbital, 2 minus 1, 1. So there will be only one node. 3s orbital means two nodes will be there. Okay. So this is the shape of s orbital. Then, when we consider angular distribution function for p, d and f orbitals, will be highly complicated. So this is complex in nature. So in our syllabus, angular distribution function for s orbital alone given, p, d, f orbital you can study in higher classes. Right? So we are going to see the shapes of p, d and f orbitals. When we take p orbital, principal quantum number may be 2 and above, right? Azimuthal quantum number 1. For P subshell, azimuthal quantum number 1. What about magnetic quantum number? Minus 1, 0, plus 1. So last class we discussed. Right? If you take the simplest P orbital, 2P orbital, for 2P orbital, what are the quantum numbers? Principal quantum number 2, azimuthal quantum number 1, possible magnetic quantum numbers, minus 1, 0, plus 1. Maybe Px orbital, Py orbital, Pz orbital. The shape is dumple shape. Okay, what is the shape of P orbital? Dumple shape. So this is x axis, y axis, z axis. So this is called 2px orbital. Now the electron density will be in the lobes. Electron density will be in these lobes. Now this is the point where electron density is zero. So this is called a nodal point in p orbital. Right? This is nodal point. And we can have a plane also. This is called a nodal plane. So nodal plane has zero electron density. So this is 2p x orbital. Because the lobes are orienting in x-axis. X-axis, y-axis, z-axis. Now the lobes are orienting in y-axis. So this is 2py orbital. Electron density will be in the lobes. This is nodal point. We will have nodal plane also. One nodal plane will be there. So what is the shape? Dumple shape for p orbital. Next. x-axis, y-axis, z-axis. The lobes are lying on z-axis, so this is called a 2p z orbital. So electron density will be in the lobes. So this is nodal point and one nodal plane will be there. So we have three type of p orbitals: px, py, pz, and its shape is dumbbell shape. Next, d orbital. So third cell has d orbital, isn't it? So last class we studied third cell has d orbital. We say that 3d orbital. So principal quantum number 3, azimuthal quantum number 2, possible magnetic quantum number -2, -1, 0, +1, +2. Right. So when we take d orbital, x-axis, y-axis. So this is called a double dumbbell shape or clover leaf shape. Okay. So what is the shape of d orbital? Double dumbbell shape or clover leaf shape. Now the lobes are present in between the axis. So this is called a dxy. So what is the name of orbital? Dxy. If the lobes are present in between the axis, this is called a dxy, right? So if the lobes are present in between the axis, y and the z, so this is called a dyz. Between the x and y means dxy. Between the y and z means this is dyz. If the axes are x and z means the d orbital is called as dzx. So what are the available orbitals? Dxy, dyz, dzx. So if the lobes are present in between the axis, if the lobes are present in between the axis, we have dxy, dyz, dzx. So these are called P2G set, triply degenerate. Degenerate means equal energy, right? So three orbitals are having equal energy. So this is called a T2G set, triply degenerate set, dxy, dyz, dzx, double dumbbell shape or clover leaf shape. So out of 5 orbitals, we have completed 3. Now consider the lobes. They are present or lying on the axis, x-axis and y-axis. So the lobes are present along the axis. So this d orbital is called dx square minus y square. Okay. Take z-axis. If the lobes are present along the z axis, this is called a dz square. So dxy, dyz, dzx are the 3 d orbitals. They are having lobes in between the axis. Now these two are the orbitals are having the lobes along the axis. So the lobes are lying on the axis, dx square minus y square, dz square. These two orbitals are having same energy. So this is called eg, called a doubly degenerate. So eg set. Okay. So totally we have 5 d orbitals and the f orbital, a 3 dimensional model is given in their book, just to check it. So we have 4f orbital, right? Fourth cell has f orbital. So principal quantum number 4, azimuthal quantum number 3, possible magnetic quantum number -3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3. So 3D picture of f orbital is given in the book. We have to know what are the possible f orbitals. F z cube, f x z square and y, sorry, x z square, f y z square, f x y z, f x x square minus 3 y square, fy 3x square minus y square, fz 3x square minus y square. So all these are available f orbitals, right? For azimuthal quantum number 3, we have 7 possible f orbitals, right? So d orbital double dumple shape for f orbital, one more same type of dumple will include, right? So the number of lobes will be more in case of f orbital, right? So 2D picture cannot be drawn for a SPD orbital. Two-dimensional picture we have already drawn now. Two-dimensional picture can be drawn for f orbital. The number of lobes are more in number, so that we can draw only 3D picture. So 2D picture cannot be drawn. So you just check in your book. So there are 7 f orbitals, right? So with this we complete shapes of orbitals. So based on angular distribution function and radial distribution function, we have obtained the shapes of orbitals. So next class we will discuss about energy of orbitals. Thank you.